Bangladesh, 2010. It was very hot and sweaty in the tiny cab. Taxi drivers around us were hooting and shouting in the worst traffic jam I was ever in. My driver was not. He was coughing his lungs out. At return to the hotel, he asked me, "Doctor, please, may I ask your advice? I cough up blood, I lost weight, and I don't feel good. Could it be tuberculosis?" "Well, big chance, yeah," I told him, "and big chance I was infected too, after spending 5 hours with him in the same car." So after my return home, I had to wait 8 weeks before I could undergo a tuberculosis test. This is because the available tests depend on the reaction of the immune system to the tubercle bacteria, and this takes time, but it was nerve-wracking. And the result, after 8 weeks of waiting, doubtful, but likely to be positive. I was advised to repeat the test after another 8 weeks. Well, wouldn't it be nice if we had a test that could just make a diagnosis instantly? And not just of tuberculosis, but of many diseases? To show you what the impact can be of good diagnostics, here are some facts. Well, did you know that 1/3 of the world's population is infected with tuberculosis? That lung cancer accounts for 1.4 million deaths per year? And that 235 million people in this world have asthma. What these diseases have in common is that they are highly prevalent but underdiagnosed, and therefore they are undertreated. This leads to a poor prognosis, increased mortality, societal costs due to loss of laboring and functional capacity, and high healthcare costs due to preventable hospitalizations and expensive treatment for advanced disease. So there is clearly a need for new diagnostics that can be used globally. Such a test should be non-invasive. It should be portable and real-time, providing immediate results, making it suitable for on-the-spot use. And it must be simple and easy to use, both for doctors and patients. But above all, it must be cheap. Well, this is what inspired me. People, I can hear you think, was she inspired by a vacuum cleaner? Well, actually, this customs officer is scanning luggage for illegal drugs with a pretty old-school electronic nose. And electronic noses are devices that are designed to trace down organic gas mixtures, in this case, that are dispersed from drugs. So how can we use this technology, which has been updated a bit since this photo was taken, as a diagnostic test? Well, by measuring our own organic gas mixture, exhaled air. Portable, non-invasive, simple, easy, and cheap. There you go. Well, every breath we exhale contains many different molecules that are the result of normal metabolic processes, but also of disease processes anywhere in the body. Diseases in the lungs, such as asthma, lung cancer, and tuberculosis, directly change the exhaled molecules. But diseases elsewhere in the body, think of different forms of cancer, also change the molecules by gas transfer in the alveoli into the exhaled breath. Well, this is how it works in practice. A sample of exhaled air is easily collected in a special inert bag, which is then measured by modern electronic noses, which are nanotechnology-driven devices that measure the complete mixture of molecules in a single measurement. The sensors of the electronic noses, the responses of these sensors are translated into a so-called fingerprint of the breath, which we call a breath print. And diseases have their own specific breath print, and this makes it possible to make a diagnosis in the exhaled air. Now, I am not a nanotechnology expert. I'm a doctor. I'm pragmatic. So I started to test a couple of these electronic noses that were designed to detect drugs, to detect asthma. And guess what? It worked. But pretty good accuracy also. And several proof-of-concept studies have now shown that it is indeed possible to make the diagnosis of pulmonary diseases, but also of non-pulmonary diseases in the exhaled air. So for low-income countries, the need of such a test is evident. There is often limited access to good diagnostics because either the hospital is too far, it's too expensive, there's a lack of skilled personnel or a lack of diagnostic equipment or maintenance. The result is that diseases are often not treated or insufficiently treated. What doctors over there need is a simple and quick test that will tell them which patient is sick and with which disease. Because with earlier diagnosis, further spread of infectious diseases can be limited, less extensive treatment is needed for advanced disease, and loss of family income due to illness of the breadwinner is prevented. In high-income countries, we have wonderful diagnostic tests, but they are bulky, they are expensive, they need highly skilled personnel and a hospital environment for their operation. But what about the primary care offices, large screening programs for cancer, and at-home monitoring of chronic diseases such as asthma? And maybe even more important, imagine if you were sick. Wouldn't you want to know the diagnosis instantly? So where do we stand now? We have all the ingredients. We have the doctors, we have the patients, we have the technology of electronic gnosis, and we have the proof of concept studies that we can indeed make a diagnosis from the exhaled air. What needs to be done now is to bring the ingredients together. Doctors and high-tech professionals need to work together to build specialized sensors that are sensitive to key compounds in exhaled breath. And they need to develop an electronic nose, especially for medical use. And ultimately, a breath cloud is formed, a large database containing disease-specific breath prints, which can be accessed by doctors all over the world, bringing swift and cheap diagnosis a step closer. So I conclude by saying Breathomics is definitely within reach. Oh, by the way, after 16 weeks of waiting, my TB test came back negative. Thank you.